Welcome to the What's New video for version 12, where we're going to give you an overview of all the new and improved features that we've added in this release. This video is intended for existing customers who've recently upgraded to the latest version and only includes details of the incremental changes and enhancements to the previous version of the software that you should already be familiar with, along with minor changes. So let's get started. Version 12 brings you a brand new, modernized user interface, with huge improvements to enhance your workflow and save you time. The interface has enhanced DPI scaling support, which makes the software look more vivid and sharp, especially on high-resolution screens. You can access both the vector and component tools from one panel, so you don't have to toggle between them, and you can use the drawing and 3D tools without changing tabs, reducing mouse miles and saving you time. Sketch carving is a brand new feature that converts a high quality image or a 3D model into a VCarve toolpath. The resulting toolpaths are quicker to machine than a 3D toolpath, and they produce impressive stylistic results with very little design input. Simply select the image or 3D model, assign your tool and tracing parameters, hit calculate, and visualize the impressive outcomes. For VCarve Pro, we've introduced a brand new VCarve inlay toolpath. Now, this tool makes the process of creating VCarve inlays quicker and easier, where the toolpath automatically creates both the plug and pocket toolpaths, mirrors your geometry, and even puts the plug toolpaths on a separate sheet that you assign using the drop-down option, making the creation of VCarve inlays even easier. In pro versions of the software, we've introduced keep-out zones. This handy feature allows you to designate areas of your workbed the machine should avoid during rapid moves from the home position and when moving between cuts within a toolpath. This is particularly useful for avoiding obstacles such as clamps, jigs, and fixtures, ensuring for the safe running of the machine. Simply draw in vectors to represent the keep out zones and assign them in the tool. Once assigned, the visibility of the zones can easily be toggled on and off for easy viewing. And when a toolpath runs into a keep out zone, the software will not make it possible for you to save out the toolpath. The 3D cross-section tool allows you to quickly create vectors from any part of your 3D model. Simply click between two points and the vector representing the cross-section between these points is made and added to your project. We've made improvements to the way that you draw in the software, where you can now draw directly in the 3D view with many of the drawing tools. Each tool allows you to modify key properties of shapes directly on the shape themselves, using handles for easy manipulation, reducing the need for you to have to go back and forth within the forms, helping for a quicker workflow. With the introduction of drawing in the 3D view, we now have the ability to toggle the drawing of vectors at the press of a button. This is useful if you ever want to see how your geometry lines up with parts of your model or machined parts of your simulation. We've made it even easier to access your componentry without having to go into the dedicated components tab. So using the drop-down menu on the document toolbar, you can now switch between active levels, adjust the visibility and combine modes of the levels, as well as add new levels directly from within this menu, making your workflow more seamless. The orthographic view removes the perspective mode within the 3D view, and this is useful for when you want to see two-dimensional objects over the top of the 3D view. For example, if you want to see how the parts of a toolpath look when lined up alongside the 3D view, simply toggle the button to switch between the two options. The software now has a brand new 3D view control. The view control is an interactive shape which allows you to quickly manipulate your 3D view, making it even easier to view along particular axes and angles. You can click on any of the faces to adjust the orientation of your job in the 3D space, or you can simply drag the control itself to dynamically change how you want your job to be orientated within your view. The new view toolbar gives you the ability to quickly and easily show or hide items from your views at the click of a button, where you can choose whether or not you want to show vectors, bitmaps, toolpaths, and components, giving you the option to focus on specific tools needed for your job in your workspace. We've added the functionality to access sheets directly from the drop-down option on the document toolbar, where you can now quickly add new sheets or switch between sheets, reducing the need for you to navigate away from your workspace to go into the Sheets tab. In this release, we've unified vector and bitmap import so you can import all of your 2D data files from one single button. When working in the 3D view, you now have access to live help prompts, where the software will track your current tool or action and provide you with handy tips on how to use the feature, whilst providing you quick access to the relevant help documentation. So that completes this overview of the enhancements we've made in this release. To learn more about the features covered in this video, head over to vectric.com, or you can download the free trial software and read the supporting documentation. Thank you for watching!